Hello and welcome to the QF-Test plugin tutorial for Jenkins. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to install and configure the plugin so it can run all your test suites. Let's start by downloading the plugin. Go to Manage Jenkins, followed by Manage Plugins. Click on the Available tab to get a list of all the currently available plugins. To find the QF-Test plugin, simply enter QF in the filter and the plugin will show up. Make sure it's selected and choose either one of the install buttons. It doesn't matter which one you choose, as you have to restart Jenkins after the installation anyway. Before Jenkins begins downloading the QF-Test plugin, it will check if you have the HTML publisher and JUnit plugin installed, and will also download those in case you don't already have them. Once the installation is complete, you have to restart Jenkins for the plugins to work. Then go back to your dashboard. The first thing you have to do is to create a new job. So select New Item and choose a name and then the style of your project, which is usually the freestyle project. Now, by clicking on OK, the job will be created and you'll be redirected to the configuration page of this job. First of all, you have to set the workspace to the directory containing your test suites. To do so, click on the Advanced button in the Advanced Project Options. Then, select Use Custom Workspace. Now, enter the path to the directory containing your test suites, which is in my case, C, My Suites. It doesn't matter if your test suites are in some subfolder, as long as they're all relative to the workspace you selected here. Next up, you'll have to add the build step by clicking on Add Build Step and then choosing Run QF Test. In the first field, you can enter the name of the test suite that this job should run. If the suite is not directly in your workspace, but in some subfolder, you can specify it here. Or you can also enter a whole directory. If you do this, every test suite in this directory will be run by the job. Additionally, you can add specific command line arguments like debug. A list of all the available arguments is found in the QF-Test manual by clicking on the Help button of the plugin and then following this link. Under the label Test Execution, you will find all the available arguments. The plugin also has a few advanced options, which you don't necessarily need to configure, but I'm gonna briefly explain them here. The first one lets you choose a specific version of QF-Test that should run this job. Simply enter the path to the QF-Test version here. The plugin will create a folder called QF-Test Jenkins Reports in your workspace, where it temporarily saves all the logs and reports so the post-build actions can save them. You can rename it right here. The last option lets you use the daemon mode of QF-Test. You only have to enter the host and port of the daemon to do so. That's it for the build step. Now, let's go to the post-build actions. To save the run logs of your tests, click on Add Post-Build Action and choose Archive the Artifacts. You will find the path to the logs in the help of the plugin. Just copy it, scroll down, and paste it. Next up, select Publish HTML Reports and click on Add. Again, you will find the path to the report in the help of the plugin. So, copy it and paste it. Also, you have to change the index page to report.html. Additionally, you can choose to not discard old reports. Finally, add the post-build action, publish JUnit test results. You know where to find the path. So, just copy and paste it. That's all for the configuration of the job, so let's save everything. To check if everything worked out, let's create our first build by clicking on Build Now. The plugin will now start QF-Test in the background, which then runs all your test suites. To get a closer look at what's happening, click on the build and then on console output. In case something doesn't work or you simply want to get more information, always check the console output of your build. Now let's wait till the test suite is finished. As you can see, our build was a success. We can now go back to the project page and then look at the test results or open the HTML report directly in our browser. That's it for the basic configuration of the QF-Test plugin. Thank you very much for watching this video.